and majestic sights galore.
Red as the bloodshed, blue as the wounded, white as the crosses on our soldiers' grave. Through the rain, through the sun, these colors never
tonight is the greatest symbol of freedom the world has ever known. Yeah. This amazing banner is so much more than brand and fabric and color, but a banner which binds together a nation. A nation which has made many different races, creeds, religions, differences of opinion, and political party. But no matter how we may be different individually, collectively, under this flag, we're all the same. Simply Americans. You know, folks, I am no different than you. I read the newspaper, I watch the news, and it seems like every day they tell me what's wrong with my America. Jobs are scarce, the economy's bad, fuel's high, there's trouble in Washington. And the very moral fabric and religious foundation of this nation is being tugged and torn at from every corner of the world. You know, I'll be the very first to admit, folks, we are not perfect. We do have our problems. But I think that you'll agree with me on a Saturday night in the great state of Texas. When I say I truly believe we still live in the greatest nation God ever created, the United States of America. What an honor and a privilege it is to know that's our family. And the men and women who have fought and died to protect freedoms and so many times we take for granted. You know, ladies and gentlemen, one of the greatest freedoms we still possess in this amazing nation is the freedom of religion and the freedom of prayer. See, it doesn't really matter whether you worship in a temple, a tabernacle, a cathedral, a synagogue, Pentecostal, Baptist, or a Catholic church. What is important is we still live in a nation where in public events like this, we are free to pray to the one true God. What an honor that is, and tonight I ask you to extend me that honor as I lead to your invitation. Remain standing for the singing of our national anthem. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, we come to you tonight on a very joyous celebration occasion. Father, first and foremost, we want to thank you for our talents and our abilities that allow us to be a part of a great sport we know is doing. Tonight we ask that you take care of the cowboys and cowgirls. Father, protect them from harm, but also instill in them a desire not only to be a champion inside the arena, but outside as well. Protect the livestock that you created by your own hands. And for our rodeo fans, we ask that for the next couple of hours, you take away all the worries and trials and tribulations of this life. Fill their hearts with joy and enthusiasm as they enjoy tonight's show. Father, last but certainly not least, we'd be remiss if we didn't thank you for the young men and women, past and present, of our United States military, who stand guard at this very moment, protecting this very freedom. Father, our only prayer is that you bring them home safe, and you bring them home soon. We ask all of this in Jesus' name. Amen. Now, ladies and gentlemen, we welcome to the arena, a very beautiful lady. Here tonight provide vocal accompaniment, beauty, and talent in the singing of our national anthem. Would you please?